This is Ryan Zimmerman, Greeley TV. I play the microphone. Yes, I do.
Ryan Donald Zimmerman was the best roommate I ever had. Pretty much we just started out as friends and we joked about making this band and kind of became really serious about it and worked hard at it, and Ryan had never sung before, so for him to be able to pick up singing and screaming as he has and just have a ridiculous amount of kids asking him every day how he gets his voice to sound like that and have him go, "I don't know, dude, I just do it," you know, it's pretty impressive. And off stage, he's a really funny, really dry humor in our band. He brings a sarcastic wit, so he always seems to have something pretty silly to say.
Ryan is straight hair. Ryan is caring smile. Ryan is skinny women's jeans. Ryan is Monroe piercing. Ryan is in love with his dog Coco.
Who's that other guy in the band? I don't know. I can't remember his name. I don't think he does anything important. Oh yeah, Ryan, our singer. I guess some people think he's cool. I don't think so. He's a big pain to all of us. He just sits around and does his hair all day. It's really quite annoying.
Ryan has the biggest imagination in the band, for sure. So he definitely made everything up. Don't believe anything Ryan told you guys. Ryan likes to walk around naked, as you guys found out last night. Actually, he likes to wear his shirt, but he doesn't like to wear his pants in the RV. It's really weird. He's pretty disgusting. He's the pervert. He likes to cuddle up on everyone. It's really weird. He's kind of a sensitive guy. I don't know. He also likes to poison us with his disgusting hairspray every day. He thinks if he traps himself in the bathroom in the RV, like, we won't be able to smell it. It's horrible. I don't know. For some reason, the stuff is poison, dude. We're all, like, choking to death every day he does it. I think he wears size 0 pants. It's kind of funny. I wear size 3. I'm just kidding. He has really cool dance moves. I really enjoy playing behind him. And he has really nice buns, too. I don't know. Other than that, he's a really nice guy. I'm really happy to be in a band with him. Thanks, Rye. You're nice. You're a nice guy.
All right, so what's the game plan, dude? We got cheerleader girls. We got the drama club girls. We got the athletic girls, like the soccer girls. Dude, soccer girls with soccer legs.
Soccer girls.
Which of all the girls at this high school, what's the group that you're going to be focusing on the most?
Mainly the dudes.
We played a high school show at Dana Hills High School. And there was some kind of contest, some fashion show with Hurley.
It was so crazy, dude. We played in, I don't know what the room would be called. It was like a cafeteria / auditorium kind of thing. Really cool stage. It was pretty amazing because there were just as many kids behind the band as in front of the band and on top of the band.
Kids were taking finals and they were kind of, you could tell they were looking for any distraction whatsoever, and we were glad to be that distraction.
My name is Peter King, and I was the MC at the first annual Walk the Walk fashion show competition at Hurley the other night. We're here at Dana Hills High School. They won, of course. The competition was between Laguna Beach, Newport Harbor, and Dana Hills High Schools. And they all got the same outfits. They all had to do up their hair and their makeup and present us with a fashion show at Hurley. And this was the school that won, and their first prize was a lunchtime concert with Greeley Estates.
We're about to rock the crap out of some kids. and most of them probably maybe even have no idea. And so they're going to come out of class in about 45 minutes, and they're going to come out to some loud muzak. So we want to know, on a scale of 1 to Narnar, how Narnar is it about to get?
It's going to be super galactic, out of this world. Narnar for sharshar.com/stimtvmusic.
All right, we got 1 minute till go time. We're about to rock it, yo. Ah!
Hi, guys. So we just played the Radical High School of Dana Hills. Anyways, we brought the rock a little bit, and the electricity cut out
twice.
Huh? You like apples? How about them apples?
We're too loud, and we brought too much craziness that the power and the school couldn't handle it, so it just shut us down. But the kids still loved it.
Totally loved it. Hey, Ryan. How's it going, buddy? So why'd you jump on the tables? Were you hungry? Trying to snack on some of the kids' lunches?
High school. I hate high school. I never graduated.
He jumped on the tables because he hates high school.
You want a cup of tea?
Yeah.
Hi, high school!
My name is Brian Champ, and I play drums.
Brian is Mr. Personality. Brian's the guy that can always be found smiling. He's the guy that that everybody knows. He's kind of the crazy one that likes to jump out from behind his drum set whenever possible, twirl sticks in the air whenever possible. Anytime there's not an element of his drum set to be played and he's got a free hand, it's usually in the air spinning a stick. And that, in a lot of ways, sums up Brian's personality. Brian loves longboarding. Brian loves lightning bolts. Brian loves the color neon green. Brian loves chocolate. Those are, to me, all those things sum up Brian's personality in so many ways. It's kind of crazy.
Brian is a loudmouth. He never shuts up.
Whoa!
But we love him. Brian loves the microphone. He loves the camera. He loves the show. I believe he's probably thinking about the show right now up there on stage. He's definitely our entertainer. Never lost for words. We get all our new lingo from Brian. Gnarly is gnarly. Everything's gnarly. Everything's rad. Everything bodacious. Anything the Ninja Turtles say, Brian says. Anything the Ninja Turtles eat, Brian eats or drinks or whatever. So he likes candy. I'm sure that's why he's always like freaking out and never sleeps and just talks all day long.
And I just ate a box of Nerds. It's had a snack attack. Snack attack!
We love him. When he's on the phone, you can hear him from a mile away. You know exactly what he's talking about on the phone. It's great. Gotta love it. Gotta love it.
Brian Champ plays drums for us. He's a great guy. He kind of reminds me of Animal from the Muppets, because he's just like crazy all over the place, and he's small, kind of like a stuffed animal, like a little doll, I guess. Just want to take him home, cuddle him, nurse him. But no, he's a rad drummer. He's a cool guy. Love him around. He digs Bob Marley. Likes the Rasta. He likes Rasta music. He likes to, I think that's one thing that I like about his drumming too, is that he brings that into our music, I guess. It's just like another outside thing, but yeah, word.
Original Greeley songs. This is what the new album sounds like. Yeah, dude.
You guys ready to get your showers on?
Yeah.
Woo! Me too. Looking gross.
So this will be my throne for the next, maybe, it might only take actually like a minute and a half, 2 minutes maybe. I think it'll be a quickie, but I'll run you through it while the experience is unraveling.
Woo! Okay, so I'm locking the door. Click.
Let's see if I can talk and do this at the same time. Hang on, I need to hold my breath for a second. Woo! Whoa! Whoa! Holy crap! No pun intended. Oh my gosh. So now I went number two. Now I'm going number one a little bit. Toilet paper. Ooh, that was nice and soft, like a little cloud of marshmallows. Uh-oh. I'm not really saving the rainforest right now. Five. Oh, man. And here's the grand finale, everyone. Say goodbye, children. Ah, let's wash our hands so I can give everybody high fives afterwards. And now I'm going to open the door. And now we're done. Woo, yeah, thank you very much. Yeah, everyone. Woo, it smells a lot better out here. Thank you. That was a really fun experience. That was a first for, I think, all of us, actually. Hey, guys. What are you looking at?
I like TRL. It's not that bad. It's cool. TRL's kind of like the, the thing that's like, oh, you've really sold out. You're on TRL. I hope someday we're on TRL. I'm not going to lie. I just really want to meet that Vanessa chick. She's hot.
Show tonight, Greeley Estates is playing Chain Reaction. It looks very similar to like a Coliseum or arena event, which it is, but this place is a smaller size arena, you might say, Chain Reaction. Actually, all this traffic is everyone fleeing away from the Greeley Estates show because our music will melt your face and destroy your ears.
Is it Menudo playing down the street?
Yes.
That might be where they're all at.
We're going to
the Menudo show.
We're going to the Menudo show.
The reunited Menudo show.
My name's Dallas Smith. I play guitar for Greeley Estates.
Dallas is a great guy to have around. He's like kind of the main songwriter. For the band, he's very talented songwriter, which is good to have in a band, because if you don't have songs, you're kind of useless. But yeah, Dallas is he's really rad, and he's like computer genius, man. So like he's a computer genius, and he's a video game fanatic.
He's the guy that runs the MySpace primarily, and lots of kids know him from online. He's the guy that is sort of the connection with fans all over the country and all over the world through like an online outlet, whether it's like AIM or MySpace. So he's kind of the one that keeps us plugged in on a lot of levels to the rest of the country while we're gone.
Dallas Smith, coming in hot. Shredder, dude. The Shredder tears it up on the silver SG guitar, like Angus Young. So sick, very talented songwriter. He's very entertaining to watch on stage. He gets kind of gnarly. Sometimes he trips and falls, and he'll be laying on his back for an entire song. It's pretty funny. Happens almost every night. I get a good chuckle out of that.
So Dallas is the computer, video game, anything electronic Dallas loves. Dallas will watch movies, play video games, stay on the computer. He could do it for 24 hours straight and still be stoked. So Dallas is the man behind MySpace. It's funny because all the ridiculous things he says, everyone thinks I say. So I'm just going to clear the record here, right here. It's Dallas who's saying those things to you.
That's here. Good old scrapage.
Have some peeps.
I don't know where the hell we're going to park this thing.
What up, dude?
Hey, kids!
Hey, baby!
What's going on?
What happened to your head?
We'll talk about it later.
Oh, man. That was a long 10-minute drive.
Is that signed by Kelly Clarkson? That's so amazing, dude. Her phone, her song, Since You've Been Gone, is my ringer on my cell phone, actually. True story. Kelly Clarkson. That's great, man. Kelly Clarkson autographed telly.
So, the Chain Reaction Show. Chain Reaction Show, once again, it's definitely the hottest show of any tour you will ever go on. I don't care if it's the dead of winter or the middle of summer, it is going to be an oven in there, all right? But the kids just go bananas. The sound's pretty gnarly, but it's cool because the place is just packed. Everyone's just totally going nuts.
We went over to Chain Reaction, and we love playing there. It's one of our favorite places. It's like a home away from home. And the kids there are always awesome. And like I said, a lot of the kids from the Dana Hills show came out and said, we saw you today. We'd never heard of you, but we came out tonight. So that said a lot, and we were super stoked about that. Saw a lot of friends we haven't seen in a long time, a lot of fans that have been coming to the Chain shows that we play. Got to see a lot of them again.
Chain Reaction. Yeah, dude, we had two shows that day. We played the high school, and then later on that night, we played the Chain Reaction. And that was fun. Chain Reaction's always a good time. A lot of kids from the high school came out, too, which was cool. They're just like, hey, we saw you today at our school. And I was like, hey, I was there, too. We played a show. And then I was like, hey, we're playing a show tonight. And they're like, I know. And I was like, no way.
I'm Josh Applebach, and I play bass for Greeley Estates.
Josh is probably one of the most beautiful men on the planet. No, just kidding. But it's pretty funny because the guy is so photogenic, it's not fair. Because every time we take photos and stuff, everyone might look like horrible. Like, we just got up, you know, and like, we only got 2 hours of sleep, and everyone's like, ugh, disgusting, like a monster. And then here's Josh, he's just like, gorgeous, dude, freaking Abercrombie model. But we all give him crap for that. It's really funny. That's Josh Applebach. And his really fun last name, Applebach. It's pretty cool. And oh yeah, he totally rocked the maraca, man. Woo! Woo! He's my inspiration to play maracas for sure. Hot. Actually, he plays in a mariachi band at nighttime. Monday nights. Sweet. 5 to 9. I don't know where I'm going with this. Well, what happened was, whenever we recorded the song Y'all the Vampire Squad, I actually I recorded like a little shaker on the recording just for fun, and it sounded horrible. But since we did it, I think his like ears were playing games with him, and he thought like the shaker made it on the recording. So he still does it. Like, he's just living in the past. I don't know what he's doing, dude. So he's up there shaking it, and it's really entertaining watching him. He really, really gets into that maraca, dude. Like, I think he likes playing the maraca more than playing his bass. It's hilarious. I'm not even kidding. It's pretty amazing.
Josh is another cutie pie. All the ladies love Josh. He's very into fashion. He's into cleanliness. He's into fruity candy like Starburst and Skittles.
Bags and bags of tropical Skittles.
For some reason, he likes really gross fruity drinks. All kinds of like juice drinks that are really gnarly.
Joshua Applebach, Applebizzle. He plays bass and the keyboards. And the maracas. He actually dances with, if you watch him on stage, he'll be like, it's really kind of funny. Makes me laugh. I hope it'll make everyone laugh, because it's entertaining. But Josh's a cool guy. He's kind of like the go-to man in a tight clinch of a situation. If you need something done, he's your man. Like today, for instance. We had a lot of stuff today to do, and he got it done because he's a soldier. He's a number one soldier. Josh Applebach joined our band about a year and a half ago, around the same time as Brian. When they both joined the band, they added a solid rhythm section. Josh had only been playing bass for a little bit, so we felt kind of intimidated by Brian's experience, but Josh was right along there alongside us, learning our instruments as we go, and Josh has always been really good at picking things up and being personable, and he picked up pretty rad stage moves along the way, and really personable. He brings the ladies out, which I guess is good for if you like ladies, which Josh does, so that's good. Ladies love Cool Josh, LL Cool J, so...
So, I'm going to be driving this bad boy from Anaheim to Phoenix. I'm going to be sure to take it slow for the children. Be safe, because we've gotten a lot of accidents, so hopefully this thing will be safe. Whatever, you know. I'm just going to sleep in here and play with the slinky. I don't know, whatever. In case you get bored, play with the slinky at night.
Tell us about it?
No.
I got some fierce strawberry to wash down a beef and potato burrito.
Pretty much decided to stop not too far into our trip because transmission was slipping and my foot feels like it's on fire. I thought the heater was going, but it was the floorboard and the transmission was running so hot, it started to slip, but it's a big bum out, but it's better than totally destroying the vehicle. Word.
We gave it a shot. We did what we could. At least it's recorded for posterity. We gave it a good try. Josh is super bummed. You showed him your buns, I'm sure. Your bulge.
I just saw my buns.
Yeah. If that doesn't make you feel better about not having an ice cream truck, I don't know what will.
It's all good.
It's all good.
Hello. My name is Brandon Hackinson. I play guitar, and it smells like poop in here.
Brandon Ives Hackinson started out on our couch. That's how I met him. He was just some dude on the couch when I came home one day, back to the apartment where Ryan and I were sharing. And I was like, who's this dude? Why is he on our couch? But he liked to play Tony Hawk too. I liked to play Tony Hawk too. And we hit it off like that.
Brandon's the guy that loves to be extreme, I think. And he is all about like the wild fashion. And he's obsessed with the 80s, 80s metal. And he's currently been rocking the Axl Rose bandana and leather jacket. Pretty impressive. Brandon is obsessed with monkeys. He has probably close to hundreds of stuffed monkeys or monkey related things. And when I first joined the band, he had a sticker of a monkey hanging from a palm tree reaching for a banana on his guitar. And he would rock the monkey reaching for the banana on his guitar. Pretty amazing.
Brandon is the scary one in the band that I really love. I grew up with Brandon. He loves stuffed monkeys. He sleeps with them every night. It's kind of a really scary thing. When we get the money, we'll get him help one of these days. But Brandon's the one in all the press photos that looks like he's gonna just kill you and like bite your head off. He's kind of that, I don't know, he's a pretty intense guy. He rocks out pretty hard on stage. Kind of try to keep my distance from him so I don't get knocked out. But totally hilarious. You never know what he's gonna do. Like, especially when he's on camera too. He's a lot like Brian. When he's on camera, you never know what he's gonna do, so.
Brandon's actually hilarious too. He's a pretty filthy human being. He's been wearing the same shoes for, actually, it's probably coming on 12 months today. Actually, today's the last day he's gonna wear the shoes because I almost threw up for an entire day when we were driving last week. Seriously, disgusting. He's been wearing these shoes, never washed them, and he ran out of socks, all right? It's just like, it was like the most horrible vinegary. They smell worse than my sweaty sweaties over there. Seriously, dude, horrible. Anyways, back to Brandon. That was the bad side. He's really funny though. He's a really cool guy. Very entertaining, very talented musician. This is food for thought. He's actually very good at karaoke. Surprised you didn't know that. He has a really good voice, and his favorite song is Vanilla Ice, Ice Ice Baby. He will tear it up on the dance floor. Hello, sunshine. It's insane, dude. So next time you see Brandon at a karaoke bar, do not challenge him to Ice Ice Baby, because you will go home crying. His stage presence, dude, that guy just, I don't know, he is like in his own world, dude. Just shredding, shredding. He pretty much rips one pair of pants every single show he plays. He gets so low, dude. I mean, he used to be a gymnast back in high school, so the dude can do like splits, you know, behind his head, dude. His knees go backwards like a Barbie doll. Like, I don't know. It's crazy, dude. So he gets down and low and dirty. He's gnarly, shreds, freaky. Yeah. I don't know. This might be useless, but I'm serious. Scout's honor.
This is for you. This is too much CSI. Thank you. I should have seen in your eyes. This next song is called Don't Look Away. If you know it, help me out.